You may ask yourself, how is this different from the American concert band? Well, if you look closely, you'll notice that this band is comprised of only brass instruments. Some of these instruments you may know very well, and some you may not. Tonight, we'll introduce you to them all. Like the American band, our band is divided into families. The majority of our instruments are conical board instruments, which means that the tuning gets bigger as you progress from the mouthpiece to the bell of the instrument. The first instruments I would like to introduce you to are the flugelhorn and the tenor horns. The flugelhorn is similar to a trumpet, but is larger and has a much more mellow sound. It serves as a bridge between the horn family and the cornets. The tenor horns are the highest members of the sax horns, which were invented by Adolf Sax. For those wondering, yes, he also invented another instrument that he only named after himself. Anyway, the horn family covers the mid-range of the band. While both are conical board instruments, baritones and euphoniums have much in common and much that is different. As you can see, the baritone is much smaller than the euphonium. It has a smaller bore and as such has a brighter sound. The euphonium which is often confused with the baritone found in American bands, is larger and is actually the highest member of the tuba family. It has a much mellower sound due to its larger bore. The cornets are the largest section of the brass tube. There are two types of cornets, the soprano cornet and the standard cornet. The soprano is pitched higher than the standard cornet and is the highest voice in our band. The standard cornet, on the other hand, which is in the exact same pitch as the trumpet, is a part of the same family as the trumpet, but like our previous instruments, features a conical bore, allowing for a much mellower and less edgy sound. The trombones are the only cylindrical bore instruments in the band. This means that the size of the tubing stays the same until the bail portion. That is essential as, without this, they would have a pretty difficult time moving their slides. These instruments are responsible for providing the foundation on which the band sits. In the English brass band, we use two types of tubas, the E-flat tuba and the B-flat tuba. The E-flat tuba is a bit smaller and is tasked with playing the higher of the two parts. The B-flat tuba, on the other hand, is much larger and can play the lowest notes in the band. Regardless, you will unfortunately hear from them later in the piece. But with that out of the way, let's listen to what the band sounds when we play them all together.
Thank you.
and variations. The theme, established at the very beginning of the piece, has gone on quite a journey. Each verse of the song is being changed little by little. We have taken our winter's sleigh ride, celebrated in the warmth of Spain, and have danced in the icy steppes of Russia. Now, we continue on to Germany and Scotland. In this final variation, you will hear almost all of those instruments I just mentioned as we come back to the United States and go on to the big top to feature our percussion section in a circus group. Merry Christmas, everyone.